boot app manually. Let's automate it in under 2 minutes using GitHub Actions. So your code goes live every time you push.
Let's get started. The first step is to create a GitHub repo and set up the project. So I'll open my GitHub. Now I'll quickly clone this Spring Boot app in my local. I'll copy this, go to my IDE, click on new, project from version control. Let me paste it here. Click on clone. It will clone the GitHub repo in my local. It's a blank repo right now. So let's convert it into a Spring Boot repo quickly. I'll go to my Chrome, search for Spring Initializer. I'll fast forward these steps as these are very common. Now I click on my pom.xml and add as main project. So my Spring Boot app is set up. Now let me create a controller for testing purpose. Let me quickly run it and test it. I can see my app is up and running on port 8080. Yes, the message is coming properly. So the next step is to set up your EC2 instance. For that, I'll go to Chrome. I'll search for EC2 console login. I'll search EC2. Go to the EC2 dashboard. Click on launch instance. Specify the name EC2. My EC2. Scroll down. I'll quickly select the operating system as Linux. I'll be needing this KPI login. I'll specify the name of the key pair, set the format as file format as RSA, select .pam. We can see the success message. Let me go to the instances. We can see the state is running. Let me click here. It is currently checking the status. Next step is to add SSH key in GitHub secrets, basically AWS SSH keys. For that, I'll go to my GitHub repo, settings, secrets, actions, and I'll add new secrets. So let me just copy this EC2 host here. Go to GitHub. As I told, I have to go to settings tab. In that, I'll find secrets and variables. I'll go to actions, and here I can add in the secret tab. I'll add secrets and repository secret part. I'll click on new, add secret name, EC2 host. The value should be this public DNS name. I'll copy this. Come here, paste it here, add secret. In the same way, I'll add two more secrets. This EC2 key. The value should be the EC2 key pair value. For that, I'll copy this. Basically, I'll open this in my notepad, copy everything, and paste in here. Click on add secret. I'll add one more secret here. That will be easy to port, and that will be 22 only. Click on add. Now, next step is to build a jar. For that, I'll run the maven clean install command, and this will generate a jar for me in the target folder. So this is the build is success, and in the target folder I can see the jar file name. So I'll be using this jar file name in my CI/CD pipeline. Next step is create a ec2deploy.yaml file in the workflow folder. So for that, I'll go to my app, right click here, click on new directory, I'll write .github, create one more directory, I'll write workflows, click enter, right click again, create new file, I'll copy the name of the deployment file, basically a YAML file. So this YAML file is added. It is asking me, do I want to add it into the Git? I'll click on yes, add. Now, let me write the YAML file, the CI/CD pipeline code. This is the name. Then this command will be used. Basically, if there is any push into the main branch, this pipeline will be triggered. Next is, I'll specify the jobs. So in our case, there will be two jobs, build and deploy. So let me copy the job, build job, paste it here. What it says is it runs on Ubuntu latest, and the steps involved are checkout code. Obviously, it will check out the code first. Then the next step is set up Java. So it will set the Java, or we can say it will install Java in the runner, in the GitHub runner. Next is build with maven. So the command will be maven clean package. Since we have already set up the Java, this command will work. Now, after that, I will upload the artifacts. For that, we'll use this command. Here, you can see I have specified the jar name and the path, that is target ec2deploy 001 Spring Boot. This is the same path, target ec2deploy Spring Boot 00.1 version. Next job is the deploy job. I'll copy that as well. Paste it here. This is the tricky part. Here we can see it needs build. That is a build job. So this job will be triggered only when this build job will be successful. Then it runs on Ubuntu or Linux that we have already selected in the starting. Then the steps are, first of all, it will download the artifact that we have uploaded in the last part, in the last step. And we have specified the path dot, so it will download everything. So here we have only uploaded the jar file, so it will download the jar file. Next step is set up SSH. This will set up the SSH. Basically, it will create a SSH folder in the GitHub, in the GitHub runner. It will pick the EC2 key pair, store it in this file ID RSA. It will change the permissions of it, and then it will run this key scan command. Next step is copy jar to EC2. Here we are running the command scp minus I, then we are specifying the key pair file that we have created here, and we are specifying the port number, then we are specifying our jar file, then we have to write EC2 user, basically the user that is, you can see it from here as well. Like if you click on connect, go to SSH client, we can see here as well. It specifies EC2 user at the rate and the public DNS name. So this is a way. So we have also specified EC2 user at the rate, and then it will pick the public DNS name from the secret. And here we have specified the path, that is home EC2 user, and in this path, this file will be copied. The next step is restart the application, or let's say start the application. The commands will be SSH. Basically, through this command, it will connect to the EC2 instance. The command is simple, SSH minus I. Then I'm specifying the key pair file, specifying the port number, and the EC2 user and the public DNS name. And here I'm killing jar file if it exists. So basically I want to restart, right? And then I'm writing the no hop java jar. The location of the jar file, the location of the application log. So what this command will do, it will run this jar file. Whatever output or whatever log it generates, it will store in this application.log file. And this end represents, it will run it in background. So let me push or commit and push this deploy.yaml file. And let's see whether the pipeline triggers or not. Let me go to the actions folder. Here I can see the pipeline automatically triggers. Let me click here. I can see there are two jobs, build and deploy job. If I click here, I'll see all the steps, and we can see already few steps are successful. Oh, and now all the steps are successful of build, and our deploy job is also started. So we can see our file is successfully copied to EC2, and application is also restarted. I can see job is completed. Now, let me connect to my EC2 instance and just verify. For that, I'll go to my folder where my EC2 key pair is there. I'll just open the terminal here. I will copy this SSH command. Click enter. We can also connect to through this EC2 instance connect and by clicking connect. So we can see we are in home EC2 user folder, and here only we have uploaded our jar file, and I can also see the application.log file. Let me just check the logs. For that I'll use tail command. Let me update the logs. I can see some error here, that is failed to run Java command. Let me just get the file, the log file. Okay, I can see the error, Java. Basically, Java is not yet installed in this machine. That's why it is giving this error, yes. So I'll add one more step in my pipeline, in my deployment pipeline to install Java. For installing Java during runtime, I'll add this command. What it will does, it is installing Java 17. So it is checking the Java version. If it is Java 17, then it's fine. Otherwise, it will install using sudo yum install command. And then it will set the Java home path. Now let me try pushing this change again. I'll click on commit and push. Now let me go to the actions. And the pipeline will trigger automatically. So you can see our deployment is successful this time. Now let me connect to my EC2 instance. For that, I'll copy this SSH key, go to my folder where my key pair is already there, open the terminal, paste the command, click enter. It will connect. Let me check. My files are there. Let me check the Java version. Yes, correct, Java version is also there. Now I'll try to test my endpoint. For that, I'll copy this public IPv4 address. Open a new tab. Hit the endpoint 8080 port. It is still not running. The reason is in the security group, I have to add an inbound rule for port 8080. It controls the traffic. So here we can see only 22 port is added. So I'll click on edit inbound rule. I'll click on add rule. It is add port number 8080. Source is anywhere from IPv4. I'll click on save rule. It will save. Let me go back to my EC2 again. Copy the IPv4 address again. Open a new tab. HTTP 8080. We can see the message coming properly. So guys, in this way, we have deployed our Spring Boot app through GitHub pipeline and automated the deployment process. I hope you like the video. Please don't forget to hit like. I'm aiming for 100 likes. Your likes and comments encourages us to create more videos like this.